Welcome to The Idea Space, a podcast devoted to sharing strategies and tools to help you make your dream life possible. I'm your host, Jen Liddy, a teacher turned entrepreneur. It's my mission to help women grow their businesses and get what they want without feeling guilty, overwhelmed, or confused. If you're tired of your ideas spinning around your mind and you really want something more for yourself, you're in the right place. Learn how to create the space to make your ideas a reality. I promise, if I can do this, anyone can. Let's go. Hello, hello. Welcome to the Idea Space Podcast. I'm your host, Jen Liddy. And this month, I am talking about the secret small shifts in our content creation process that makes things a lot easier for us. And I'm going to get right to it this week because I see this in my clients. So I'm pretty sure if you're listening, you struggle with this too. Content creation takes up a lot of your time. And actually, it's not just your time, it's your energy too, because you have to think about, what do I say? And then you have to write it, or you have to publish it, or even decide where to publish it, right? And is it just going to be text? Is it going to be a video? What picture should I put with it? And then you will worry, will anyone even see this? Am I going to all of this trouble for nothing? And it's basically what I've come to call the constant treadmill of content creation. And it's all in the name of creating trust with your audience. And I know how important this is, but the worst part of this is that you're spending a lot of your time writing emails, writing social posts. Maybe you're doing podcasts, maybe you're making offers, but these are things that nobody ever seems to take you up on. They don't engage with you. And I know that you're doing exactly what the gurus tell you to do, right? So you're like, why isn't this working? And if this sounds like you and you're going a little bonkers, you might be making some of the mistakes that I used to make in my marketing. And these are mistakes that I see really talented, smart entrepreneurs making in their content all the time. And they're so frustrated. Like, everybody talks to me about content creation, and the very first thing they say is, I am so overwhelmed. I am so paralyzed. I'm so stuck. I don't even know what to do. I don't even know what to say. And so today I'm unpacking a big mistake that too many entrepreneurs are making because they simply haven't been taught this one little secret that I want to talk to you about today. Now, the bottom line is about this secret that there are some people in your audience who are a bad fit for you. Let me explain. Who are you thinking of when you create your content? Because that person that you're holding in your mind is very important, because that's the person that you're pouring your heart out to. The stories that you're telling, the tips that you're giving, the content that you're creating is for that person that you're holding in your mind. Now, if you don't have a person in your mind, that might be a big problem, but I want you to start thinking about who that person is that you're speaking to. And this person is on a continuum. Let's just call it a continuum. Your audience is on a journey or a continuum. And where they begin is that they are problem unaware. And then they move into being problem aware. And from there, they go into being solution unaware. Like, they have a problem, but they're not even aware that there's a solution for them. And then they might learn about a potential solution and they become solution curious. And then they become solution ready. So let's cover that again. This spectrum is problem unaware, problem aware, solution unaware, solution curious, and solution ready. And I want you to start to think of your audience on that spectrum. Your mindset on this alone is a total game changer for your content. Because mistake number one that I see people making all the time is that you might be speaking to people who may not be ready for you or your solution. So who do you hold in your mind when you create your solution, when you create your content, when you're talking about the problems, when you're talking about the solutions in your content? Who you hold in your mind is vital. Is that person problem unaware? Is that person solution unaware? Because I want you to understand that this is way more about having that right niche or the ideal client avatar. I mean, I'm all about knowing exactly who you're talking to, but this is going deeper. I'm asking you to go deeper when thinking about your audience and thinking where that person is, that exact right audience member, where they are on their journey. Let me give you an example. The other night I was talking with a life coach. She's a friend of mine, and she doesn't understand why the women that she's talking to in her content never make any changes. Like, they just stay suffering and complaining with all the same things, and they never take her offer seriously. Like, they won't get on a consultation call with her, much less hire her. So obviously she's frustrated because she knows she can help. She knows she's got great tools. She also knows she's got great content. And she said, you know, I know they're hurting. I know they need to feel better. So why don't they take me up on my offers to talk? And so I asked her, what are they doing right now to feel better? Like, they have problems, and what are they doing to feel better? And I said, you know, are they reaching out to life coaches? Are they thinking, oh, I really need a life coach? Or are they thinking, I need to order a new pair of shoes or boots from Nordstrom. I just really need another pair of boots right now. That will make me feel better. Or are they just buying a box of wine on their way home from dropping the kids off at her ex's house, right? Or is she numbing out on TikTok or Instagram to feel better right now? And when I asked her that, and I said, you know, are they doing this kind of stuff? She was like, oh my God, right. They don't even know that they are in a problem. These are the people that she's spending all of her time talking to in her content. But these women, they aren't ready for her help. They're not ready for a life coach because they really might not be aware that they have a problem. Honestly, they might just be thinking, well, you know, things are shitty. This is how things are. They're kind of shitty for me. It's just this way and it sucks. So let's go have some more wine or let's buy another pair of shoes, right? If your audience is not even problem aware, then you are spending way too much time creating content that's falling on deaf ears, because it's like you're spending all your time in your content creation trying to convince your audience that they have a problem. You're trying to convince them to see that they have a problem. And if that's what you're spending a lot of your time doing, content creation is going to be real freaking hard, because all you're doing is the heavy lifting to an audience who really isn't that interested in your solution. So this makes a lot of sense, right? But not a lot of people think about this when they're thinking about content creation. Who are you speaking to most in your content? You know, do the people that you're speaking to, first of all, let's start at the beginning. Do the people you're speaking to know they have a problem? Seriously, like, they might not. I mean, to you, I know it's so obvious, but they might just think like, yeah, this is a sucky situation and that's just the way it is, and they shrug, right? Two, if they know they have a problem, if they're problem aware, are they aware that there are solutions? They may not be. And I know that like, you're so immersed in your solution that you're like, how could people not know this is an option? But don't assume everybody out there is solution aware, because frankly, I walked around with a rash on my chin for 3 years because I didn't know that the solution was to go gluten-free, to go see a different kind of nutritionist and learn about how to do this from the inside out. I just didn't know that there was a solution. Now, number three, if your people are aware of the solution, so they're problem aware, they're solution aware, are they solution curious? And what I mean by this is, do they believe that the solution can actually work for them? Because they really might be thinking that your solution is for other people, not them, right? So your content has to speak to wherever your audience is on their journey. Are you speaking to the possibility for them? Are you helping them believe that the solution could work for them? And four, if your people are solution ready, are they ready? Are they the right people to invest time and energy and money into your solution? If you remember on another podcast, I was talking about having the right asses in the right seats, like having a group of CEOs who are on the edge of burnout in the seats versus a group of kindergarten teachers or preschool teachers who are on the edge of burnout. We have to have the right asses in the seats, because for your specific solution, are these people ready to invest in that solution? So they might be solution aware, but are they solution ready? If the answer to any of these questions is no, then your journey to get them connected to you and converting with you is going to be long and painful for you. So who are you thinking of when you create your content? Who are you speaking to? Here's how I was making this mistake back in the beginning of my coaching business. I was really focused on speaking to women who were running their businesses like a hobby. They were focused to, you know, these were women who were basically focused on their like little kiddos, and they just couldn't spend the time or the energy or the money on their business. And I was so focused on helping them because I knew that they needed help, just like, you know, your people need help, right? I was so focused on these women at the beginning of their journey. And these women at the beginning of their journey are rarely ready to invest time, energy, or money in their business. They kind of have to be ping-ponged around a little bit, like a, I always call it like a pinball, right? Like bing, 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 before they will invest in themselves. And none of the marketing I was doing was working because they thought they were problem aware, but they were nowhere near solution ready. And I'm not saying don't speak to those people who are not problem aware. That can be part of your content. And if you want to talk to the people who are on the beginning side of the spectrum of who you work with, that's fine. Just know that their journey is much longer. And if you spend all of your energy there and all of your time and all of your content there, you're going to be frustrated. So spend the time and energy in your content speaking to people who are problem aware and looking for a solution. What do those people need from your content? Now, if you want content creation to feel easier, pay attention to your customer readiness. And if you're ready to make real changes in making content creation easier, then you're going to want to join my content workshop. I have a new workshop called Crack the Content Code, and it's a 2-hour deep dive workshop to help you understand exactly what to say to your audience, because that's always the question I get. What do I say? And then how to say it. You're going to walk away with a workbook filled with ideas and 4 weeks of content planned out that you can implement right away. Now, this is taking place on January 28th from 11 to 1 Eastern Standard Time. And yes, I promise there will be a replay. So if you can't join us at that time, come get the replay because you can watch it several times, right? And you want to register? Awesome. I would love to have you there. Go to www.jenliddy.com/code. And I know I always say the www and it's so stupid, but for some reason at my website, you need the W's. I'm giving podcast listeners $10 off the registration. So you just have to use the coupon code content10. And I would love to see you there because I know how much having the right kind of content builds a relationship with your audience. And that is where the magic happens. If you want conversions, they're going to happen only if you have connection. So make your content creation a lot easier this week by putting your headspace in with a different type of audience member. Move from that person who's not even problem aware into somebody who is at least problem aware and solution curious. Because I don't want you to spend your time and energy convincing. You don't have to convince anybody. Get that audience member who's hungry for your solution. Thanks for staying through. I would love to meet you at my workshop next on the 28th, not next week, on the 28th. And I will see you next week on the podcast. Bye. Thanks for joining me today. If you like what you heard, please subscribe to the Idea Space in your podcast app. And tell that friend of yours who needs some help getting where she wants to go. I'd be so appreciative if you left a review because then we can help more women create the space for their ideas too. Go to jenliddy.com/free to grab the many free resources there to help you move forward. And I will see you next time. Bye.